party people, Judea Hartley here, and welcome back into the one and only AM show. Happy Thursday once again. All right, y'all, my heart is beating out of its chest, and no, I'm not hiding that at all, honey, because at the top of the show, we promised, Nadine, Freddie, and myself, promised and informed you guys that we have two flat-out fantastic guests that are going to be joining us today. And guess what, my brothers and sisters? They're here. That's right. Listen, I am super stoked to have my favorite YouTubers with us. Wherever you are, I want you to infuse that enthusiasm, show your love for my people, Miss Destene and Mr. Brandon Sudduth. I am super excited to have you guys here. Hi!
How's it going?
Yes! Oh, God, I'm doing so well. How are you guys?
It's great, man. Life is really, really good right now for us. So
yeah,
that's all I can really say.
listen, you guys are, as I just stated, my favorite YouTuber. So, and you guys are just always so humble. So I'm brag on you just a little bit. I sure am. Destene and Brandon Sudduth, you guys, you're talking about acclaimed YouTubers. You're talking about 1.17 million subscribers on YouTube. You're talking about almost 500,000 followers on Instagram. You are talking about the extreme social media influencers. Yeah, y'all, I'm talking about the boss and CEOs of Drip Check. Would y'all please show some more love to Ocean's parents? Yeah!
You know what? You are too good at this.
Yeah, way too good at this.
Oh, God, I'm just... Yes, I have to tell you guys this just before we begin our conversation here. I, from the bottom of my heart, I am deeply moved, deeply, that you two took the time out of your busy schedule. You guys are bosses and CEOs, YouTubers. You guys are parents, right? I know that your gorgeous baby girl is on the way. God is so real. Amen to that. And I don't take that for granted. I don't, because people don't have to say yes. They do not have, so many people are entitled. These people do not have to say yes. And these people took the time out of their schedule for little old me. I remember watching you guys. I'm like crying, sorry.
Don't do it. Reconsider.
Reconsider.
I remember watching you guys, and I was on a dead-end job, and I would watch you guys on my lunch break, I would get whatever food I could find, and I would sit in my car, and I would watch you guys, and you guys were the highlight of my day, because you received so much in one video. It wasn't just a God-fearing, smart, intelligent black man showing us how to love his beautiful, God-fearing, brilliant wife. It wasn't just that. We got all of that. But then we also got lifestyle. Then we also got styling tips. We also got comedy. We also got faith. So I appreciate that, because so many people who have the visibility and the platform that you guys have, they disregard opportunities like this if they don't know you. They just do. If you don't have 20 million views, they, oh, who's that? Who? They disregard it. And I don't count it lightly. The fact that Destene called me, like, I was just fangirling out. Seriously, I'm like, honey, she called me. She called me. Me, honey. She called me. So
we appreciate that so much.
Yeah.
And I think that we've been in that place before, you know? So it's very real for us. And that's always something we're going to do. We love to give, opportunity and be a part of things. And First of all, when I pulled you up, I was like, oh, the energy is great. We're definitely doing that, okay? The views don't matter. The numbers don't matter. The energy was just there. So absolutely. Thank you so much for having us. We don't take it lightly either.
Yeah, we're very thankful for this opportunity. So
thank you, guys. Well, let's really just unpeel this onion. Let's get into the meat of the sandwich, you guys. So I want to know, you guys, of course, I know that y'all met at a pool party that Destene wasn't even, oh, honey, she's a stalker. I met at a pool party. Yes!
No.
I'm a stalker, not Destene. I know you guys. Oh. I know the whole story, not Destene. I'm a stalker. I know all of the details. So I know that you guys met, and of course you're married now. And I don't want to spill all the details, but let's start from the genesis of it. No, Destene is beautiful. I'm the stalker. It's me, honey. Oh,
I thought you were saying Destene was a stalker. It's funny how she ended up at the same pool party as me.
Oh, well, I was wondering why he was looking like that. I'm like, I was not stalking you.
It's funny how she just happened to be there when I was there.
Des, tell us what happened. How, in your own words, how did you guys meet?
And tell the truth.
You know what? And I'm gonna take it all the way back. Yeah, so first of all, I had just come out of this space of being super down and out. You know, everybody around me was getting married, having babies. I mean, you know, you get into that sunken place of singleness.
Yeah.
So I had just told myself, you know what? We're going to get out of this. You're going to get out of this rut. I'm going to start hanging with my girls, going out, doing all this stuff. So a girlfriend of mine, which ended up being a mutual friend of his, invited me to a pool party at her house, and I ended up going, and then I saw Brandon walk in. I was like, wait a minute, he's tall, dark, handsome. I was like 6'3", oh. So immediately I started doing my research. I was asking my girls, I was like, does he have kids? Does he have a job? Does he have a car? Like, what is he like? Is he good? You know, so, but that was it, pretty much, on the first meet. We shook hands, we said hi. That was it. And then maybe about a month later, we ended up
running into each other again at a day party that we were
wow.
at.
Wow.
At that point, that's when Brandon became the stalker. And he was like, can I buy you a drink? Come on, can you just talk to me, you know, stay for a little bit longer? I was like, sir, I'm leaving. Like, no, you had your chance a month ago. You didn't say nothing.
Yes.
So I ended up accepting the drink.
Of course she did. Of course she did.
And he invited me to church that following day, because this was a Saturday and we went to church on Sunday. And literally, I kid you not, every single weekend after that, it was just like we were linking up, hanging out. I mean, we just
been rocking ever since.
Yeah, ever since.
Yeah, yeah.
Ever wow.
since I was like, okay, she comes to. I had to see if she was about the church life. You know what I mean? I was like, let me see, let me ask her, and she accepted, of course. And so we went to church, and I was like, okay. That's the first major obstacle out the way right there. So.
Yeah, which was different. I was like, nobody ever asked me on the first date to church.
Yes.
Like,
yeah.
That's different, girl. That is different. I didn't wanna spoil it. I didn't wanna tell the story. I'm like, y'all, I'm a real life stalker. I know how my people met. But I wanted them to learn how you guys met. And I love that you guys have sort of documented. You guys have documented this union, of course, on your social media handles, but specifically on YouTube, because that's where I found you guys first. And I watch everything concerning you guys. So I love how you guys really expressed your love on the Dare Future Wifey podcast. And you guys talked about how you knew each other was the one. It's like, of course, we're going to get into drip check. You know, my dress was $300, Brandon. It was $300. Brandon, it was $300, Brandon. But we're going to get into everything else that you guys do. But I thought it was just so important. It was just so important to lay that foundation. So as I know what you're knowing that Brandon was the one when you heard him pray.
Yes.
Elaborate on that, my sister.
It was just different. I had never heard a man like really just kind of really talk to God about his goals and the desires of his heart and the goals for us and just really voice where he was at that point in life. It was just something just so special and different about it. I'd never been around someone that was so just like, you know, ready to go to God, humble, and you know, it was like I wasn't even there. Ooh. It was like, this is the conversation I'm having with God and you're here, and I was down for that. That was something, I mean, I was just down for it. Even to this day, it's just something that brings us closer together. That's really just how I knew. I was like, man, this is awesome. Like, if you can talk to God and not be afraid that I'm here, I don't know. It's just, it was different. It was different.
Yeah, I love that leadership ability, because I always say, I'm a pastor back here in New York at my church, and I always say that God works in order. He's very, very structured, right? Of course, it's God, and then it's the husband, it's the wife, it's the children. Like, we all work together, and I think when you can see your husband lead in that way, go to God on your behalf. Like, have a relationship with God. He already embodies that, and everybody else just echoes what he already embodies. That is something to pay attention to. So, Brandon, I'm going to head over to you, my brother. How did you know that this beautiful gem was your wife? Because, Brandon, let me take 10 seconds. She is beautiful.
She is.
Destene, you are so pretty. You are so pretty.
She's a baddie.
Thank you so much. You're beautiful as well. Thank you.
Brandon, Brandon, look to your left or right. That don't make no sense. Brandon. No, that doesn't make sense. Who looks that good, Brad? Who looks that good on a Tuesday morning? Why is every outfit, why does that look like gold? Why does that look like that? Fantastic. So, my brother, you tell me how you knew that this was your rib.
Absolutely. So, for me, you know, I've always been big on energy and just the vibe. And, you know, there's certain people that when you come across them, it's just like a wind of their aura that sweeps over you. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And when I saw her, first of all, she has the most beautiful smile that I've ever seen, like, in life. You know what I mean? And I'm not just talking her up. Like, she knows how I feel about her smile. Mm-hmm. So, when she smiled at me, it was just like, okay, I could just see that she was full of positive energy. Mm. And that's a major thing for me. Like, if your energy is not there or the vibe is off, then we're not even gonna have a conversation, because I could just sense it and I can feel it. You know what I mean? And so when I started talking to her, I got the positive energy just came over me, and I was like, okay. And like she said, the first time I really wasn't in a space to be trying to pursue anybody. Mm. I was just kind of coming out of I was kind of flipping that switch, for lack of a better term. And so, you know, I was coming from the party boy B to now, I was like, okay, it's time for me to settle down, find someone, meet someone, and do life with someone. And what ended up happening was, when I first met her, we didn't talk after the pool party. We didn't talk again for a month. And then it's crazy, because when I ran into her that second time, again, that positive energy swept over me. And I was like, you know what? I have to pursue her. I have to see what this is about. And the reason the drink came into play is, it's not necessarily that I really wanted to buy her a drink. I think what it was I just wanted to prolong her being there so we could talk a little bit.
Ooh. So
the drink was like, okay, here's a drink to kind of get a conversation going. And then from there, you know, we were talking and I was like, okay, cool. Now let's see if she's, you know, she has faith. She's a God-fearing person. Let's invite her to church. But it was really her positive energy that swept over me. And I'm really big on that. So that's how I knew.
And my toes. He said I had nice feet.
You do, girl. You sure do. Listen, look, I speak to my this. Baby corn every day. I say, you shall look like Destiny. That corn on that baby toe I speak to, you do have nice feet.
Yeah, I'm a foot guy. If her feet would have been jacked up. No, hey, positive energy or not.
Oh my God, hilarious. I love
but
that.
That was a bonus for me that she did have nice feet. Yeah. She had a nice smile and she just really checked all of the boxes that I was looking for. Honestly, yeah. That I had been praying about, you know what I mean? So
I love that. I love that. I love how God is so evident in your marriage. I love how you guys never hide away from that. I love how you keep him at the forefront, at the center, and you credit him. You credit him for the longevity that your marriage will have, for the communication that you guys have. It's so evident, I promise you. I know that when you go on YouTube and you see numbers, like, I know you guys know this, and it's so beautiful that you do, that there are people behind those numbers that really, really, really look up to you guys. I'm one of them. So we're gonna transition a little bit. So you guys, I want to know what you did before you just completely stole all of our hearts on YouTube. Des, I know that you were in corporate America. Brandon, I know that you're incredibly, incredibly hardworking. That's why the both of you got to where you are today, because both of you work so hard. But Des, if you can tell folks a little bit about what you did before you blew up on Instagram and YouTube.
Yeah, so I was actually in human resources. My latest job actually was at Capital One. And it was pretty much just like we were working from home, of course, because of a pandemic. Mm-hmm. And so, yeah, it was just like a lot of desk work, a lot of meetings, and a lot of hiring, interviewing, training. It was just kind of, we really picked up social media as a kind of just something to do because we were home all day. Mm-hmm. We were bored and we just thought it would be fun to just pull out a camera and start doing it. So that's what we did. But yeah, my last job was in human resources at Capital One.
Wow. I think that's so. And B, we're going to head right on over to you. You know, I got my shoulders ready. We're going to
head. Get them ready. Get them ready.
We're going to head right over to you, B. But Des, I asked you that question because I know, but I wanted people to know it's a story of inspiration. It's so inspirational how one idea just really got built into this almost like legacy that you guys are leaving behind for your children, behind for your family. This body of work, right? This camaraderie, this community, this large community that both of you have built. I love that you just picked up that's what I wanted to know. Whose idea was that? Now, I know I'm not in Houston, Texas, but Des, I'm praying to God that you made grilled cheese and tomato soup today because your girl is doing her cooking lessons. I know you cook. Before we get into that, B, tell people like what was your scope of practice? What was your scope of work before you guys blew up on YouTube?
Sure. So I've been in the financial services industry since 2007. So I've worked at companies like Fidelity and TD Ameritrade and TIAA. So that was kind of what the industry I was in. And you know, it's a very great industry. I'm sorry. It's a great, very great industry. But at the same time, you know, I always knew that my passion, it was really just like entertainment. I really feel like I was put on this earth to entertain. And so it was kind of like, I needed a outlet to be able to do that. And so, you know, me and Des kind of came together and was like, okay, what can we do? You know, we used to watch people vlog on YouTube and stuff like that. And we were like, man, we can do this.
Yeah.
And so our first vlog was a cabin trip where we just used our iPhone and we just vlogged the whole cabin trip. And It was a success. Like, we uploaded it to YouTube and, you know, we got some views on it. And we were like, okay, you know, we can do this. And So what ended up starting off as kind of like a side hustle ended up becoming like, okay, this can be bigger than that. And So yeah, the financial services industry was what I was doing, but you know, this is kind of what we got into because I felt like my passion was in this.
Yeah, no, I mean, just fantastic. And we see that on YouTube. I was going to ask you guys, but you guys just sort of just answered it so we can chat a little bit about it. How did you grow your following on YouTube? If you guys have not subscribed to Destene and Brandon on YouTube, you are not living right, but you could get... You could repent and get right, and you can look them up and make sure you hit that notification bell and make sure you hit that subscribe button, y'all. I promise you it's gonna bless your life in more ways than one. But I think one of the ways, one of the million ways that you guys have grown your platform is one by being yourself. So, like, yeah. So many people feel like they have to have the perfect aesthetic, even though y'all do. You have to have the perfect aesthetic or... top-notch equipment, you know, when you're filming your first video, or you gotta talk a certain way or act a certain way that, you know, you really not that way. You know that that's not really your personality. But you guys, that sincerity has a way of transcending through the screen. I'm letting you know. So with that and all of the prank ideas, can you guys elaborate a little bit more in terms of how you grew your YouTube channel to almost 2 million subscribers?
So I'll start by this. Initially, our channel was supposed to be just a travel channel. We were really just supposed to, like, you know, go places and film and vlog just to kind of give people inspiration on why this particular destination might be a destination of interest for them. But what ended up happening was, obviously, when COVID hit, we weren't doing a lot of traveling. And so we had to pivot, and we were like, but we still want to entertain. We still want to have the channel. What can we do? So then we were like, okay, let's just start doing pranks on each other. And so we were like, okay, we kind of were a little iffy on it because, as you know, pranks can sometimes go one way or, or another. Luckily we both had pretty thick skin and tough skin to be able to handle it. But we just basically were like, okay, let's just go ahead and do pranks. And so we started doing pranks and things of that nature. And then I think what ended up happening was the Shade Room actually picked up one of our pranks.
No, it was our engagement.
Oh, yeah. That's okay. I'm sorry. Yes. So we did the engagement video.
Yeah, we got engaged.
And we got engaged and we posted that on TikTok. And I think the Shade Room picked it up and they posted our engagement video on their platform. Huh. And from there, I think it just started taking off after that.
Yeah, it just took off. This was, you know, back when getting posted on the Shade Room was like a really big deal. I think now it's just kind of, you know, virality is a little bit more common now. But yeah, that engagement video, after that, things just literally start flowing out of control, actually. And then, of course, TikTok was a huge, huge, avenue for us to grow. We hit it off really good on there. So, yeah, I think it was just us just naturally transitioning life. And then we just got into vlogging. That became fun and just easier because we could just go throughout our day and just share, and it wasn't something we had to really just, like, you know, perform. Ooh, I'll say right. that. So yeah, it's just really been us just being natural, being true to ourselves, being who we are. Even it's so funny because we go places all the time and people are like, oh man, y'all are actually really like that.
Yeah.
Like, y'all are really who you are on screen. Yes. And so yeah, it's just, that's why we love it so much, because we can truly, genuinely be ourselves. And over the course of, it's been 4 years now, which is crazy, we've just really developed a strong community that really takes to us.
Absolutely. We're going to cut to some of you guys' videos as well. Of course, I have that. But I wanted to speak to what both of you just said about actually being like that and being like that in real life, like just really building this community. I know you guys know this. But it is so evident that it is, that this is God ordained, that what you're doing, your YouTube channel, I want to see them, you guys, if you can put both of us on, that what you're doing, your YouTube channel, it's just, it's so evident. It's so evident that it's God ordained. You guys are changing people's lives. Like, you really are. Like Brandon, with your comedy, you're changing people's lives. With your respect to your wife, like, with your respect as a man, as a man who takes care of his family, Destene, you're changing people's lives with just how you're showing us how to be organized, how to love, how important it is to be kind, how important it is to be ladylike and business savvy, just in so many, in so many different ways. I think I'm trying to pinch myself now, because I still am not over the fact that you took time to speak to me. Well, you guys, I want to invite all of our viewers right into you guys' world, into your Instagram, your social media world. Let's take a look at Destene and Brandon on Instagram, you guys. Here's our first video.
This is already bad. The cup won't even stay off.
It's because you ain't got no hair. Okay. All right.
Ready? Yeah.
All right, say it.
I trust you.
No, say I trust my wife.
I trust my wife. Ah! Oh, did you? Oh, thank you.
Thank you. It's the arms. You ain't got no hair.
It's the shoulders. It's the shoulders. Brandon, did you really think she was going to hit you?
I don't know. I trusted her, but at the same time, you just never know. You know, you never know, maybe on her mind, maybe I did something to make her mad that morning or something. So she needs an opportunity.
I know. Well, speaking of mornings, you guys, let's take a look at our second video. It's, I mean, hilarious. Destene was like pouring something. This is how I get something to drink. This is how my husband gets something to drink. Like, just hilarious, funny videos like that. Let's check out the next one. Destene, my brother does the same thing. Opens it up, chugs it. I'm like, excuse me. Like, have respect for everybody.
I know. I was like, now what made you come up with that idea? Is that what you do? That's when I learned.
That hilarious.
Look, I ain't got time to be getting straws and cups. I'm thirsty. I gotta just get it when I get it, you know?
I know. You guys, we have so much more to chat about. We're gonna talk about Drip Check. We're going to talk about Brandon's podcast. We're going to talk about you guys' this IVF journey. Like, I mean, so much more to talk about. And of course, your beautiful baby girl. We're gonna head over to a quick commercial break right now, but I want everybody to hang tight in their seats, because you guys, we have so much more with my faves, Miss Destene and Mr. Brandon Sudduth, when we return. We'll be right back after these messages. Hopefully I can stop crying. We'll be right back. My favorite YouTubers. Everybody, welcome back into the AM show. And please welcome back Destene and Brandon Sudduth. Now, you guys, I only have just a few more minutes with you. But you guys, I want to get into, like, the other side of this, right? Tell everybody about how your clothing brand, Drip Check, came about. And when I tell you, these people can dress, honey. I promise you, these people look stunning wherever they go. If we can get that B-roll, they have this gorgeous commercial. We're gonna show that commercial as well. They put it on their Instagram. It's like sexy, comfortable, sleek, chic loungewear. And I'm like, so here for it. Let's get that B-roll going as they tell us about how Drip Check was birthed. We can get that, you guys. Yep. Okay, there it is. Yes, y'all. This is, yes. Y'all better go on my people's site. This is their site, you guys. Look at this. I mean, you guys, they have hats. They have the t-shirts. They have the sweatshirts. They have the pants. You guys, how did Drip Chat come about?
Yeah, so, you know, when we were doing our vlogs and stuff like that, basically we would get dressed and we thought it was just kind of funny to exaggerate the prices. We were just being like funny. So, you know, we would put on our outfits and I would say, you know, my pants cost $4,000 and my shirt costs $8,000.
He would never, by the way. That's what makes it really funny to me. I'm like, yeah.
Because I would never pay that. But, you know, we just thought it would be funny, you know, to we were just clowning around. And so, you know, then we named it. We were like, okay, let's call this a drip check, right? Because it's our drip. We're letting people know our outfits and what they cost and things of that nature. And then we were like, man, you know what? This can actually be something like major. So let's see what we can do with this. And so that's when we got with our management and we were like, hey, let's do like a little merch line and call it Drip Check, because that's kind of what we're known for when we do our vlogs. That's kind of what people know us for, you know, even on IG, they'll be like, let's say if we're going out somewhere, people will be like, they'll be like, I bet you those pants cost like $4,000, didn't they? And so that's just kind of how it was birthed. We just wanted to kind of give people an option to be able to shop with us.
And, yeah.
You know, the quality's good, the sustainability is good on the clothes, and that's how we named it Drip Check.
I love it. Y'all have to check out Drip Check. I'm certainly going shopping after this because I love it. Well, you guys, this is not the only baby that you guys have birthed. Brandon, my brother, you also have a podcast. Give us the details on all of that so we can hike up those subscribers, because you're doing great things.
Yes, ma'am. The name of the podcast is called Flip That Switch. The reason why we decided to name it that was because, you know, a lot of podcasts that go on, you know, they're talking about like drama or sports or things of that nature. And we wanted to kind of do something different. We wanted to kind of bridge the gap between someone that's in their 20s coming into their 30s, because those are kind of the most meaningful years, right? It's like you go through high school, and then when you get out of high school, you got to figure out what you want to do with your life. And now really adulthood is happening at this moment. So what we did was we wanted to create a concept to be able to talk to us if we were in our 20s. So right now, being the age that we are, if we wanted to tell ourselves something in our 20s, what would we say, right? To help the next generation come up. And so we decided to name it Flip That Switch, because that's exactly what's happening. Like, you're flipping that switch and going from college into adulthood. And what is some advice that we can provide to you guys to help you make better choices than maybe we made, or navigate life a little bit easier than we navigated life? And so that's basically what the concept of it is.
I love that. Oh my God, Destene and Brandon, I absolutely love that, because you're almost like helping you are essentially helping young men and women, right? Instead of judging them, but actually offering guidance and directions and showing us the way. Now, speaking of beautiful things that you are birthing, the obvious is so clear. You guys, Brandon and Destene have documented their IVF journey, and God is so good. Destene is actually expecting a drop-dead gorgeous baby girl. She is pregnant! Destene, how do you feel?
You know what? I feel great. A little tired these days, but we're coming down to the wire. So, I mean, it's just been... it's been a journey, you know, it's been an experience. We're so grateful, we're so thankful for it all. And I'm just so blessed, and we're just so thankful to be able to document this. And you know, it's so crazy because when we first started this, we were like, man, is this even something that people of color go through? Mm. And that was major to find out. Like, when I started opening up about the journey, when we started, people just started coming out of the woodworks. And it's like, oh my gosh, we look like you. You look like us. Yes. Like, y'all went through this. And it's just so crazy how far we've come. And we're just so thankful that after the first cycle failed, that we are able to now have a positive experience. And it's just been such a blessing.
Yeah.
And you guys, I wish you so many blessings, so much peace, God's guidance, like divine joy, because you guys have really, really just changed the game, changed the world, and you guys have done that together. I think my last question for you guys is, how does it feel to be in this space now, right? This space from going from Capital One in the financial industry, having a failed IVF cycle, right? Not knowing that you'd get almost 2 mil on YouTube, building your Instagram following up to 500,000 people, releasing Drip Check, coming out with Flip the Switch. I mean, God is with these people. How does it feel now to be in this beautiful, aligned space?
I mean, if you know what's funny, it feels good. I think the thing is that for me, so me and Dez are different in this space, right? Because Dez is really just sitting back and appreciating the journey, appreciating, you know, kind of celebrating the wins and the success we've had. And I'm kind of like that too, but my mind is always like, okay, what's the next thing? Yeah. You know, what do we do next to impact and make me more of an impact on people? Because again, you know, it kind of goes back to my passion of, I feel like I was put on this earth to make an impact, right? So it's like, okay, what's the next thing? What can we do next? And I mean, the child, having the baby is just like a full circle moment, because it's like you said, to go from a no, and you know, we literally thought, okay, that was the end. And then we were like, okay, let's do it again. And for God to bless us on this time, it was like, okay, it was just meant. It wasn't a no, it was just at this time, not at this particular moment.
Yeah.
And so really just celebrating that. And Destene, I mean, she's been slaying this pregnancy. She's been killing it. And I don't know how she's doing it. I'm her husband, but I always tell her I'm still a fan. Like, I'm your biggest fan at the end of the day, because you are out here representing and you are really, really doing your thing. And so I'm so proud of her. But I'm just looking at it like, okay, what's the next thing? What's the next opportunity for us? I love it.
Like, you got, and Destene, I know that you are just gloating in so much joy and so much peace right now. You guys, if you're not following them, they are on YouTube. Let me just get this out there, honey. Again, they're on YouTube. Destene and Brandon Sudduth. Make sure you subscribe. You can find them at Destene Sudduth, Brandon as well. Destene, and Brandon, I want to thank you guys. I hate that I have to let you guys go, but I just want to thank you guys. I promise, like, I will not be a stalker. I want to stay connected. I would like to book you guys to come out. Like, we'll talk. Please, absolutely. Can everybody show their love for my favorite YouTubers, Mr. Brandon and Destene Sudduth?
We really appreciate it, and we thank you.
You guys, thank you so much. Thank you for joining us. I certainly will be in touch. Oh my God, I'm gonna go cry now. Destene, thank you so much. Girl, I appreciate you so much. And Brandon, thank you so, so, so much, you guys. I absolutely will be in touch. And it just meant everything to me that you came on today. Everything. I needed this. This was therapy for me.
We appreciate you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Bye, guys. Woo! Yes, sir! Woo! All right, y'all, we're gonna take a quick commercial break. We will be right back. Yeah.